ونشكره نستعينه سبحانه وتعالى نستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ به جل وعلا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وعبد الله ربه حتى أتاه اليقين صل اللهم وسلم وبارك وجدد وضاعف وعظم ومجد هذا النبي الأمين وآله الطيبين الطاهرين وارض اللهم عن أزواجه وأصحابه وأحبابه وذرياته والتابعين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله أحثكم وإياها على طاعته أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته أما بعد يقول مولانا عز وجل في المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قال إبراهيم رب أرني كيف تحيي الموتى قال أولم تؤمن قال بلى ولكن ليطمئن قلبي قال فخذ أربعة من الطير فصرهن إليك ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا ثم ادعوهن يأتينك سعيا واعلم أن الله عزيز حكيم. We are still with our father Ibrahim, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi wa ala alihi al-khalil alayhi salatu wa salam, especially in days like this, where the Hajj, the pilgrims, have just left Arafat. Maybe just around a couple of hours ago, having spent the whole day on the mount of Arafat in Mecca al-Mukarrama, with labbaik, with dua, with imploring Allah Azza wa Jal, with begging Allah Azza wa Jal, with asking Allah Azza wa Jal, with humiliating and humbling oneself before their Creator Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, with confessing of our sins and shortcomings before Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, with asking Him, knowing that we are absolutely helpless, absolutely hopeless without Him, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, to grant us the ease, to grant the Ummah ease, Ya Allah, in this day, Ruknul Hajj al-A'zam, in the day of Arafah, Ya Allah, the great day of Rukn of al-Hajj, where your Hajj have just left the mountain of Arafah, Ya Rabbal Alameen, grant us with the barakah of this day, all of us forgiveness, Ya Allah. And grant the whole Ummah ease, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And grant the Ummah unity, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And put in the Ummah of your Rasul, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, mahabba, and love for each other, and care for each other, and transparency with each other, and help with each other, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And make this Ummah, Ya Allah, shining more and helping of others, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Make them merciful and granting mercy and channels of mercy. Make them realize the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bi ihsan, Ya Rabbal Alameen, without the imtihan, Ya Allah. Ease the tests of this ummah, Ya Rabbal Alameen, and grant this ummah, Ya Allah, easement and khair and good and help and care, Ya Rabbal Alameen. In this day, day of Ruknul Hajj al-A'zam. Ya Allah, grant us all shifa and healing, Ya Allah. And those people who are still requiring healing, Ya Rabbal Alameen, give them healing. Those who are suffering, Ya Allah, ease their suffering, Ya Rabbal Alameen. The children of the Ummah of your Rasul, Ya Rabbal Alameen, grant them all guidance. Keep Iman in their hearts and in their minds and in their eyes and in their ears, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Don't leave us or them alone for a second, Ya Allah, or to ourselves for a split second, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, with the day, Ruknul Hajj al-A'zam, Ya Allah, show your mercies and blessings unto the whole Ummah of Muhammadun Rasulullah. Ya Rabbal Alameen, Ya Allah, accept from all the Hajjaj, anyone who was on the Mount of Arafah today, Ya Allah, accept from them their Hajj and grant them total and absolute forgiveness, Ya Allah, and enable all of us to be blessed to be on that site in the day of Arafah, in the next times, and accept it from us. Innaka sami'un mujibun qareebun lid-da'awat. يا أكرم الأكرمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. وإبراهيم صلوات الله عليه وسلامه, he reminds us with the Hajj anyway, it's all with him and our mother Hajar عليها السلام and our father إسماعيل عليه الصلاة والسلام. It's all interconnected, all connecting you and each one of us back to your grandfather أبو الأنبياء خليل الرحمن, the father of all the prophets, your father, who was calling لبيك اللهم لبيك thousands of years ago, inviting you to come to the house of Allah to witness the tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal in action with لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. There is no associate that we worship or obey, Ya Allah. Not power, not money, not others, nothing, not hawa, not deviation, not self-deification, not, Ya Allah. We became free testifying, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah became liberated us from any other shackles, from any other slavery, from any other obedience but to you, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika lak. Labbaik. Inna alhamda, all the praise is to you, Ya Allah. Wa ni'mata, all the giving is yours, Ya Allah. No one gives but you. No one takes but you. No one elevates but you. No one puts down but you. No one connects but you. No one disconnects but you. No one puts up or down but you. No one gives but you. No one deprives but you. Inna alhamda wa ni'mata lak. All of it to you, Ya Rab. All of it. Always, yani, in these days, such as the day of Arafah, it's all important for all of us, if we can, to, yani, I understand we're here, but maybe we can stand with our hearts with our brothers in Arafah. If we can't stand with our bodies, maybe our hearts can stand on the Mount of Arafah, spiritually speaking, yani, to have this sort of, at least, we are with you. We are not separating Arafah. The whole Ummah is with you. Some of you, some of us are standing there physically. Some of us are standing there with their hearts. If our bodies cannot stand on Arafah, our hearts are standing on Arafah. Not to equal that. Nothing is equal to that. I can just to say. Al-Khalil alayhi salatu wassalam, we mentioned last week, and we're still talking about some aspects of the seerah of the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam, and some aspect of their dhuq. We mentioned sometimes the issue is issue of dhuq, refined taste, issue of looking into things. How did the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam see things? How did their parents raise them to be as they were? Maybe you can argue, it's Allah who raised them anyway. وَلِتُصْنَعَ عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي خَيْرٌ. لكن Allah put reasons as well for them. الخليل عليه الصلاة والسلام mentioned to Allah in this ayah, قال ربي أرني كيف تحيي الموتى. يا الله, show me how you give life to the dead. قال أولم تؤمن. Allah tells him, didn't you believe? Aren't you a believer? أولم تؤمن, haven't you already believed? Haven't you been, يا إبراهيم, you are the one who's been talking to all the people from young age about Iman, from breaking the idols to the people that we talked about last week, to the stars, to the moons. You are, أولم تؤمن؟ قال بلى. No, I am a full believer, absolutely. ولكن ليطمئن قلبي. But it's so that my heart settles when I hear you address me. يعني, well, not I hear you, when you address me, Ya Allah, when you tell me, أولم تؤمن, aren't you a believer, Ya Ibrahim? When you do dhikr of me, Ya Allah, because when you do dhikr of me, what happens? Then I do dhikr of you, you do dhikr of me. ألا بذكر الله, Allah says, تطمئن القلوب. By the dhikr of Allah, the hearts become tranquil. And when you do dhikr of me, then my heart becomes tranquil. So I am saying, when Allah says, أَوَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ قَالَ بَلَى بَلَى إِيمَانْ, I am full with Iman. وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي, but your dhikr of me makes my heart tranquil. Your dhikr of me makes my heart at peace. Your dhikr of me fills my heart with ease. ولذكر الله أكبر. You make dhikr of Allah, but whose dhikr is greater of you? In a way that's suitable to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, obviously. Him of you, not you of Him. Him of you, not you of Him. In a way that's suitable to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. A rahmah that He sends you. A ni'mah that He gives you. لا ذكر الله أكبر. The dhikr of Allah is greater than you of Him. The khalq, all the involuntary things in you and the rest of the creation are in His dhikr anyway. Your test is in your voluntary faculties. Do you choose to make dhikr of Him or not? But in your involuntary faculties, you already are entirely with the rest of the creation in His dhikr. As He mentioned, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in kullu shay'in illa yusabbihu bihamdih. Everything but is in tasbih, in observation of the tasbih and the glory of Allah Azza wa Jal. Oh, Ibrahim, some people say, how can Sayyidina al-Khalil alayhi salatu wasalam says, Rabbi arini kayfa tuhyi al-mawta, show me how you give life to the dead. And he's the one who said في سورة البقرة للنمرود, right? ألم ترى إلى الذي حاج إبراهيم في ربه أن آتاه الله الملك إذ قال إبراهيم ربي الذي يحيي ويميت. Ibrahim goes to النمرود and tells him, my Lord is the one who gives life and death. Already. And now here he says, أرني كيف تحيي الموتى. And that's why we said it's not a matter of Sayyidina al-Khalil alayhi salatu wasalam doubting. No. Doubt that's contrary with Iman versus Iman. Lakin here love and more love is the demand or is the wish, I should say, of al-Khalil alayhi salatu wasalam. I want to take you probably remember coming talking about this issue. Ya Allah, show me how you give life to the dead with Uzair. Sayyidina Uzair, I think in the biblical traditions they call him Ezra, maybe, I'm not, you know. Uzair, alayhi salatu wasalam, he came, he's a prophet who came after Zakaria. Right? يعني from Bani Israel, alayhi salam. Uzair, he goes, Allah speaks about him in the Quran, أو كالذي مر على قرية وهي خاوية على عروشها قال أنى يحيي هذه الله بعد موتها. هذا historians or علماء of tafsir يعني say Uzair came after the king Bakht Nassar who killed the Yahud and did lots of evil things with them in Jerusalem. فعزير عليه الصلاة والسلام came, they said in Jerusalem, مر على قرية, قرية يعني village, القرآن الكريم يعني small town. وهي خاوية على عروشها. And he looks at Jerusalem, عزير عليه الصلاة والسلام, as the ayah indicates, that without, the ayah doesn't say Jerusalem, the Mufassirin say, just so we can be clear. Allah says, وهي خاوية. It is empty, the whole city is empty, destroyed entirely. You know, as Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْمُلُوكَ بَخْتِ نَصَّرْ was a king. وَإِنَّ الْمُلُوكَ Allah says, إِذَا دَخَلُوا قَرْيَا أَفْسَدُوهَا. Kings who seek to own, because that's their purpose, to own rather than to ensure justice. To own. إِنَّ الْمُلُوكَ إِذَا دَخَلُوا قَرْيَا أَفْسَدُوهَا. When they enter a village, they cause corruption so they can keep ruling rather than ensuring justice is there. وَجَعَلُوا أَعِزَّةَ أَهْلِهَا أَذِلَّ, Allah says. And they make the honorable people, they want to dishonor the honorable. Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ يَفْعَلُونَ. This is how their way is always like that throughout history. They want to make the honorable dishonorable and the dishonorable honorable. This way you cannot distinguish who's honorable and who's dishonorable. وَلِتَسْتَبِيلَ سَبِيلَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. So you know, Al-Quran gives you, as Allah says, so you understand the way of the mujrimeen. طيب. هذا سيدنا عزير عليه الصلاة والسلام, Allah says, أو كالذي مر على قرية وهي خاوية على عروشها. He comes to a village, to a city, and it's entirely destroyed. It was filled with life before. Now it's all destroyed. And then سيدنا عزير عليه الصلاة والسلام, Al-Quran Al-Kareem says, يقول أن يحيي هذه الله بعد موتها. The plants are burnt, the animals are killed, the human beings are slaughtered, even the bricks are burnt and destroyed. Nothing is left. This is what they do, right? Not just in the old days, in the new days and the old days and in every day. الشجر والبشر والحجر. The trees, the humans, and even the stones are destroyed. And I don't think, يعني leaving a stone by itself, looking good. No, it's still stone, no life. Yeah, but it looks good, destroy the stone. أو كالذي مر على قرية وهي خاوية على عروشها, القرآن الكريم says, and he asks, عزير allegedly عليه الصلاة والسلام asks, the Quran says, he asks, we're just saying, because the Quran did not say عزير, the name. Says, أو كالذي, the one who passed by the village while it was destroyed, and he said, أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. How can Allah give life to this after its vast, entire death? Complete death. The ayah continues, Allah says, فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ مِئَةَ عَامٍ. Allah willed for him instantaneously, for Uzair, to die immediately. 100 years, Al-Quran Al-Kareem says. Mi'ata'am, 100 years. How Allah gives life to the dead? 100 years die. Allah says, thumma ba'atha. Then Allah gave Uzair, or gave that man, most of the Mufassirin, all of them, they say Uzair alayhi salam, gave him life back after 100 years. Yani maybe if everybody spans their orbit in time and space, Allah willed for the time of Uzair, that spin to stop, and the rest is going. Everybody is going, his orbit stopped. 100 years until it passed, the circles passed. Allah says, ثُمَّ بَعَثَ قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتِ. He tells him, the Quran says, Allah asked Uzair, or asked that man, how long did you stay? قَالَ لَبِثْتُ يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam answers Allah in the Quran saying, I must have slept a day or even half of a day. Why the Mufassirin says Allah took his life in the beginning of the day, and when he gave him life it was time for sunset. He looked, he says, oof, I slept the whole day. Sunset is almost there. قال كم لبث الله تعالى من القرآن يا عزير or without saying عزير how long did you stay قال لبثت يوم يا الله I stayed a day أو بعض يوم not even a day some of the day قال بل لبثت مئة عام Allah tells him no but indeed you stayed 100 years فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنى Remember, look at your food. The Quran tells him, look at your food and drink. What, you brought some figs and some grapes? Huh? Look at them. They haven't changed their nature. They're still the same. 100 years. Huh? You're saying, أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَا How does Allah give life to this after its complete destruction? Look at the ta'am and sharab, your food and the drinks. The juice that you brought, where's that juice of yours that you brought, let's say, if the ayah is indicating the juice. But sharab, drinks, look at it. What happened to it in 100 years? لم يتسنى, Al-Quran tells him, hasn't changed a bit. It is just like the minute you left it. As if the time entirely stopped, and now it just resumed with all its effects. Huh? Anti-aging people need to look into this. There you go. Oh, anti-aging here, anti-aging there. Khair, inshallah. People will live 100, 125 years, maybe 130 years. Mahu al-umr is not by how many years you live. It's by how many good choices you make. Age is not determined by how many years you live. But by how many good choices you make in that age. Anyway, let's see the wisdom. قال كم لبثت قال لبثت يوم قال بل لبثت مئة عام فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنى وانظر إلى حمارك And then Allah tells him what? Look at your donkey. You came here with your food and donkey. Look at your donkey. How we give it life from nothing again. For 100 years, it almost entirely disintegrated. Look how the bones come. Look how the flesh is coming, the muscles, the tissues. وَانْظُرْ إِلَى الْعِظَامِ كَيْفَ نُنْشِزُهَا ثُمَّ نَكْسُوهَا لَحْمًا فَلَمَّا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ The whole picture now is right in front of Sayyidina Uzair عليه الصلاة والسلام قَالَ أَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ The ayah continues by saying, the ayah is sealed by Uzair saying, I already know Allah can do everything. Huh? He mentions the Qudra. First he said what? How? He doesn't doubt the Qudra of Allah. But he finds it ajeeb. Ya'jab min al-Qudra. Ajeeb, yeah. You might, because why is it ajeeb? Sometimes to us, we find something, we say from something, something else can happen, can develop, can evolve. But it's entirely destroyed. Nothing. There's nothing left. How is this Qudra? So the ajab from the Qudra, rather than denying the Qudra of Allah, Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam, anna ajib, how is this Qudra? He continues at the end of the ayah to say, أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ I am in absolute knowledge that Allah is all powerful over everything. He doesn't need a cause and effect. I know that already. He creates without the cause or the effect. Verses with Al-Khalil alayhi salatu wasalam, طبعاً مقام الله ومقام عزير نبي الله. No problem. We love him. لكن مقام الخليل is different. أبو الأنبياء بطل التوحيد. The hero of the prophets, the symbol of Tawheed that he was walking. Al-Khalil did not say, Ya Allah, how does your Qudra give life to the dead, to this? What did he say? قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى Ya Allah, show me how you give life to the dead. I know you do, and I don't have any questions about how amazing it is. I know it's amazing, but I am not here to witness your action. I want to witness your presence. I want to be with you. Show me.
قال أولم تؤمن. He tells him, aren't you a believer? Haven't you already believed? قال بلى بلى.
Of course I have. You already know. Of course I have. ولكن ليطمئن قلبي. They said that.
Remember Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, al-Kalim. So we are moving.
في روضة الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام, in the oasis of the أنبياء صلوات الله وسلامه عليهم, from الخليل to عزير to الكليم, موسى صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. موسى الكليم في طه, في سورة طه, الله tells him what? He is going with his cane, huh? سيدنا موسى. وما تلك بيمينك يا موسى? What do you have in your hands, O Musa? Doesn't Allah know what Musa has in his hands? Of course he knows. لكن love, محبة, makes things like that. What is with this, with your hand in your hand, in your right hand, O Musa? What does Musa? Musa picks up. He understands Allah is opening for him an extra channel of mahabba. He knows what's in his hand. He doesn't need to tell him. Lakin now that Al-Kalim, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, knows that Allah is opening for him, there is this breeze of mahabba that is coming onto Musa, special extra mahabba. يعني like today in Arafah, today day of rahmah, especially when the hujjaj were on the mount of Arafah. يعني even if your time is 7 hours, whatever it is, if you could spend some time while they're still in Arafah, inshallah khair, inshallah khair. I have no text for that, like inshallah khair, you are with them. At least in the time they're making dua, you're making dua. Ya Allah, ya labbaik, Allahumma labbaik, labbaik, ya Allah, ya Allah. Anyway, يعني you pick up on the seasons of qabool, seasons of acceptance, seasons of accepting your dua, seasons, opportunities of extra paroling and forgiveness and admission. Huh? That's what it is. Al-Khalil, Kaleem alayhi salatu wasalam, Musa, Allah tells him, وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى? What is it that you have in your right hand, يَا مُوسَى? And Allah is all-knowing. قَالَ هِيَ عَصَايِ. Al-Kaleem alayhi salatu wasalam, what does he say in the Quran? He says, Ya Allah, it's my cane. But that's really the answer, right? You ask a question, you get an answer. But Musa did not stop here. أَتَوَكَّأُ عَلَيْهَا. Ya Allah, it's my cane. I use it to lean on it while I'm walking. وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَى غَنَمِي. And then now he's talking. And I use it also to guide my herd of sheep. وَلِيَ فِيهَا more. وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ أُخْرَى. And I use it for other things. And he wants to talk about other things now. He wants to be in Allah's presence and special address. It's not that Allah does not know, Allah knows. But Musa does not want to stop. Allah opened for him. He doesn't want to stop. Ya Allah, it is my cane. Enough. It's my cane is enough. خلاص. What is in your hand, right hand, is my cane. عصاي. End the story. لا. ما هو الفهم عن الله. Understanding what Allah Azza wa Jal opens for you. Seasons. Seasons of rahmah, seasons of maghfirah, opportunities. And most people lose in this world from missed opportunities. That's all. Not that there were no opportunities. No. Allah sends you opportunities of hidayah, whether it's by places or by people or by things that He puts in front of you. You choose to have a missed opportunity. That's all. When you lose. When you win, you take advantage of the opportunity. That's all. Anyway, just like Al-Kaleem, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, takes the opportunity and then he wants to what? He wants to prolong these moments of special presence with Allah. Al-Khalil Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam does the same thing. He says, he wants, Ya Allah, arini kayfa tuhyi al-mawta. Awalam tu'min? No, I'm already, show me how you, but I am already a believer, but I want to I want my heart to be especially in your presence. When you address me, awalam tu'min, aren't you a believer? This is now a special address. I am soliciting your special presence, Ya Allah. I am soliciting you in my dua. I am soliciting because I know if I ask you, you answer me. So therefore, I am asking you, so you answer me. I am doing dhikr of you, so you do dhikr of me. And I know when you do dhikr of me, my heart comes to tranquility. وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي.
Well, that's the idea.
قال فخذ أربعة من الطير فصرهن إليك. Take four pieces, take a bird, cut it in four pieces. And put every piece on a different mountain top. Find four different mountains. يعني take a bird and slaughter the bird. And put the bird pieces on different mountain tops.
Ajeeb.
ثم ادعهن.
Then those pieces from your place, even though they're on the mountains, call upon those pieces.
يأتينك سعيا, Al-Quran Kareem says. They will run seeking you.
They're pieces of birds, they're not the bird.
They will come all seeking you, unite, and reform that animal that you just separated into four pieces and put it in different mountains on earth. They'll come seeking you. وَاعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Know that Allah is Aziz and Hakim. Ajib here, a couple of things. He tells him, خُذْ أَرْبَعَةً مِنَ الطَّيْرِ فَصُرْهُنَّ إِلَيْهِ. Take that bird and make it into four pieces. يعني show me how you revive the dead or how you give life to the dead. Take a living and what? And kill it. Can you kill a living? And see the four pieces that are dead? Can you give it life? And therefore, some of the Fasireen said, when Ibrahim al-Khalil told Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Allah, show me how you give life to the dead. It was given to him, a command was given to him, show me how you slaughter your son, giving dead to the living.
You want to see
how life is given to the dead? Try to give dead to the living. Well, life and death are all with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not with you or anybody else. The one who gives life is him. The one who takes life is him. You can't kill the living, even if you try to slaughter it. Nor can you give life to the dying, even if you bring everything you have. Well, that's what it is. لا إله إلا الله. خذ أربعة من الطير. Take this tire, this bird, make it on four pieces, then call it back and it will come running to you. You become the center of gravity to it. The يأتينك سعيا. Their سعي is towards you. You become their point of سعي. They're running, walking to you.
عجيب.
Why? By my name. Not by you,
by my name.
What I will to make you.
Remember what Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani allegedly, yani,
when he won over Shaitan in this argument, when he told them, you don't have to do any fara'id, khalas, you don't, you know, no salah, no siyam, mashallah, you're done, you're ready to go, khalas. You have become such a complete mu'min, now you can do anything you want.
Well, Sheikh Abdul Qadir allegedly told them, and I know you are Shaitan.
Allegedly, Shaitan tells him, غَلَبْتَنِي بِعِلْمِكَ يَا عَبْدُ قَالَ. You overcome me, you have become victorious over me with your knowledge. He says, no. With the knowledge that Allah taught me. I don't have any knowledge, it's His knowledge. بِعِلْمِكَ يَا عَبْدُ الْقَالَ. He says, with your knowledge. He says, لا, بِعِلْمِ اللَّهِ. With the ilm from Allah, not my ilm.
طيب.
What the ishara from this Al-Khalil puts all these four pieces of bird on different mountain, four mountain tops, then he calls them, then they come to him. The hand of Al-Khalil, طبعاً, what is Al-Khalil anyway when we say Ibrahim Al-Khalil? Al-Khalil, يعني the one who's so close to Allah. So close to Allah. يعني رباني عليه السلام. Entirely رباني. Everything and he hears that which Allah pleases Allah. He sees that which pleases Allah. He says that which is pleasing to Allah. He walks to that which is pleasing to Allah. He touches that which is pleasing to Allah. He never does things that does not please Allah. So he's entirely Rabbani Khalil. He's with Allah. Everything in him is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khalil al-Rahman. And therefore, the hand of al-Khalil that's who is filled with the love of Allah, even if it cuts, it does not separate, it unites. The hand of al-Khalil, even when he seems to be cutting, but he doesn't give life, it gives death by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command. It does not divide, but it unites. So therefore they come to you. And that's why the one who is filled with the love of Allah sees these things. Why do you think the pebbles were making tasbih loudly in the hand of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why do you think the mountain of Uhud, as in Sahih al-Bukhari Muslim, was moving under the feet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why do you think the tree was walking to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because that human being that's filled with the love of Allah Azza wa Jal, he becomes the pole of gravity to everything around. They recognize that he is walking by Allah, to Allah, from Allah, by Allah, with Allah. ثم ادعهن يأتينك سعيا واعلم أن الله عزيز حكيم. الخليل عليه الصلاة والسلام, Allah sealed the ayah for him. Know that Allah Aziz Hakim. Aziz means he's not in need of anything for anything, yet everything is in need of him for everything. He's not in need of anything for anything, yet everything is in need of him for everything. Allah gave you, Ya Ibrahim, the power to divide these birds, but yet when you called them from the death, from the dead, they came back to you by my will. And I am not in need of anything for anything, yet everything needs me for everything. Hakim. Why? There's hikmah. There's wisdom. Though may Allah Azza wa Jal open our hearts to that wisdom and to other wisdoms. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر. أشهد أن سيدنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم الشفيع المشفع في المحشر. صلى اللهم عليه وعلى آله أهل الفقه والنظر والعلم والأثر, وعلى من بآثارهم اكتفى واهتدى واعتبر. عباد الله, اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه. Be conscientious of Allah the way you should be conscientious of Him. Present with Him the way you ought to be present with Him. اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه. راقبوه مراقبة من يعلم ويعتقد بأنه يراه. Observe him the way that you know that you are observed by him سبحانه وتعالى. وادخروا من دنياكم لآخرتكم عملا يحبه ويرضاه. Use your dunya to take from it to your akhirah sustenance that is pleasing to him, not to you. وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّهُ لَا يَضُرُّ وَيَنْفَعُ. Know for certain, no one can harm you or prevent harm from you but Allah. وَيَخْفِضُ وَيَرْفَعُ. No one can put you down or take you up but Allah. وَيَصِلُ وَيَقْطَعُ. No one can connect you or disconnect you but Allah. وَيُعْطِي وَيَمْنَعُ. No one can give you and no one can deprive you but Allah.
واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه قال تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم. بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين أعلي مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه، من أراد بهم غير ذلك فهده يا ربنا سواء السبيل. آتي أنفسنا تقواها، زكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اشف اللهم مرضانا، عاف مبتلانا، فك أسرانا، ارحم موتانا، اغفر اللهم لنا ولوالدينا ومشايخنا من له حق علينا، من على الخير يعاننا، من عن الشر أبعدنا، لمن أوصانا بالدعاء يا الله accept from all of us on this blessed day, the day of ركن الحج الأعظم يا رب العالمين, the day of الحج الأكبر يا رب العالمين. We ask you and implore you and beg you to forgive all our sins يا رب العالمين. يا الله us and our parents and our grandparents and our great grandparents يا رب العالمين and our children and our grandchildren until القيامة يا رب العالمين. On this day ركن الحج الأعظم, the day of الحج الأعظم يا رب العالمين, we ask you and implore you يا الله to grant us guidance يا الله, to keep guidance with us يا رب العالمين, and to never make us misguided يا الله, and to never leave us without you for a split second يا رب العالمين, without your guidance and without the guidance of your رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يا الله, never keep us, never make us separate from him in the day, in the night, vision, dream or presence يا رب العالمين. يا الله all the ummah of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, gather them together يا الله, unite them together يا الله, put baraka in them يا الله, put rahma in them يا الله, put rahma in them for each other يا رب العالمين, reconcile among them يا رب العالمين, forgive all their sins يا رب العالمين, ease all their tests and challenges يا رب العالمين. يا الله grant the entire humanity ease يا الله, grant them all رحمة يا الله, grant them all healing يا الله, grant them all guidance يا الله, and then grant them all blessings يا رب العالمين. اغفر اللهم لنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات, إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين, وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله.